Hello, this is George Lees again. In his own living room, the sun is pouring down. And rather than show how I'm being defrauded by the law courts, the gods have asked me, in the dream I had 2 nights ago, to reveal all of the secrets that Greg Hallett has tried to get out to the world. Because that's about the ownership of the whole world. And it's quite alarming to see that all of his stuff is being taken down from the internet one by one. You've seen the videos I've made in recent times on FDR and the massive global frauds that always lead to world war, and you've heard me read out Greg Hallett's written transcripts on how the Skulls and the secret societies and the Mercers and all of the university warmongering systems. On that this morning, all you hear about is the Scottish people electing their sports personality of the year. Yeah, and it's within days of one of the massive storms, one of the biggest that I've ever seen in my life. The whole of Perthshire was underwater, large chunks of the Borders region was underwater, and Hoyk was nearly washed away, 600 people evicted from their homes. Yeah, and all of that is because I'm reporting now, progressively, the war crimes of all of the super elites that run the world since the Pilgrim Fathers sailed. Okay, that's the revolutions, the genocides, the holocausts, and all of the things that Greg Hallett has reported, most of them have disappeared. Yeah, I'm quite stunned that this one is left online. That's Greg Hallett report number 6, the abdication of the Queen. But you now cannot see all of this stuff continually through the whole of the interviews, and I think the Laws of Succession one cuts off within a minute or two. Yeah, and these are the videos that were made largely with Jim Fetzer, and Jim is now talking to the new one, and the website is all over the place. They're in a state of panic. They do not know what to present, because if the old one is genuine and all of these pictures have torn World War II and the profiteering apart, as you saw the other day, the Lake Mugglesy stories and Ian Fleming helping them or the Nazis out of Europe. Yeah, and but if that is so all of that leads to the declaration that the Queen has already abdicated, and that was the last one. Number 6 was the last one that was available in 2012, round about December 2012, I think that is. And I've made several visits. You visited this page many times. Last visit 16/7/2015. Last visit for that one, the Laws of Succession. Yeah, those are the ones that talk to Fetzer about the legitimate claimants coming from Portugal and Greg Hallett being in touch with them and his attempts to impose their legitimacy and to present it to the Queen. And in some of these videos he already mentions her abdication. I'm not concerned about having a new king or queen. I'm concerned about having a democracy that is capable of living without committing genocide to keep its power base. Yeah, that's what happens all of the time. Okay? And so, let's have a look at the structure of his website. There were only 6 reports when Greg Hallett went missing, and the new one doesn't look anything like the old one. And Jim Fetzer is the man in the middle, because he's interviewed both. They never talked about anything up to the last couple of months about the old stuff, but I noticed that, to be politically correct, the new one is now talking about the old issues. And now some of them don't have a soundtrack, so some of them don't have pictures. And in the good old days, when you looked at numbers 1 to 6, you could sit down and you could scan down on your computer as you listened to them talking, and you could see the transcript and the beautiful photos of everything they were talking about as evidence that everything they were talking about was true. And many of those things were publications in Punch with the authors of the illegitimate children of Queen Victoria and all of the other issues around Her Royal Highness Queen Elizabeth II. Yeah, and the writing to the Queen
and the posting of that information is spookily like what happened to me. But in my case, because my case is so public and it's so well known across Britain and the world, they've had to divert temporarily from the execution step. Okay, so let's show you the order in which I looked at these this morning, and let's just click on it again. So this is his website. It's called The World of Truth, and he used to send to me bulletins on new stuff and publications and PDFs that he was selling to keep himself alive, because as declared in one of these, he came out in New Zealand the year that New Zealand won the World Cup final, and he left Auckland the day they were playing in the final, because he knew that the bimbos in New Zealand and many of the police would be committed to that, and he was able to fly out and land safely. For a time he was alleged to be living in Wales. I don't know where he's alleged to be living now, because of all of the trivial arguments about his legitimacy, I'm no longer his friend. But he was educated when I was his friend, according to the false plant who has now replaced him. He was educated at Kelso High School in Scotland. That's my school. And the Lothian and Borders Police have received emails querying whether he was at that school to Gordon Watson, the chemistry teacher, my best mate when I was a boy. Okay? And all of it is suggests to me that the original, very innovative researcher, Greg Hallett, has been topped by the monarchy. Yeah, I don't know who the assassins were. And when you see all of the political plants that John Paterson's been imposed, and there's a man who was running, I think he's an MP in East Sussex, and he was an enemy of John Paterson's when we met. Now he's my Facebook friend. He's cited on these reports further down. Let me show you how difficult it would be to watch numbers 1 to 6 in a simple internet search. So there's 6. The abdication of Queen Elizabeth. Royal Chancellor Greg Hallett continues to expose the illegitimacy of the incumbent British monarchy in Jim Fetzer. The World of Truth Net. Hallett Report number 5. Yeah. Okay. That's the same paragraph describing report number 6, and we're learning in the text that we're going to learn about number 5. Greg Hallett Report number 5. Laws of succession try to subvert, yet the biggest secret. Lord Chancellor Greg Hallett exposes the biggest secret, and there's no details of the contents of that. So let's open them one by one in that order, and I'll show you first how difficult it is to find all 6 of them. Yeah, there's the new one in front of those sinister looking boards in the historic buildings that I saw in the Dunedin place. Yeah, with all of the people in the New World Order plants working out of that. Yeah, that's the Freemasons. Yeah, that's the Burns Club people, and that is the Dean of the Medical School. none of them will talk to me now. Queen Elizabeth II is illegitimate. That's the new one too. 49 minutes talking, Greg Hallett, The World of Truth. Yeah, I don't think that will be Jim Fetzer. I think those are the ones that are made on by Windows in the World, and he's a kind of loony looking guy, and the Windows of the World company is in the Twin Towers that were brought down for a laugh. Yeah, did you know that? Yeah, since they've done that, they've taken it down. Okay? And they no longer proclaim that the Windows of the World are the absolute truth. And those people that made those have been defaming me in my analytical way, and John Paterson and anybody else that claims that the true Greg Hallett has changed his themes. And when I actually accuse the new Greg Hallett of not exposing anything about the history of world wars and the Gallipoli conflict, because remember, he's an Anzac through and through. Yeah, he lived off the toe of the South Island on an island out there. Yeah, and none of his stuff, none of the stuff mentioned the history of Gallipoli and the massacres in the Mr. Bean joke that was laughed at the Olympics. Yeah, but maybe that's why he was disappeared before the Olympics occurred. Yeah, so that's a loyalist Kiwi, the world's experts, Oh no, he lived 12 months or so beyond the Olympics, but that was the year 2012 when they disappeared him. Yeah, and I had not even discovered the Mr. Bean joke at that time. Okay, I don't know whether he's unaware of it, but with a man of his intellect and historical knowledge, it would be stunning if he did not know that Mr. Bean, played by Rowan Atkinson, was actually the war correspondent for Gallipoli. Okay, and all of the other modern day crimes, yeah, he was reluctant to talk about them, but they did talk about the attempts of people in intel to kill them when they were meeting the Portuguese claimant in the castle. I think it was at Sintra. Okay, and goodness knows whether or not those people have been topped, but yesterday I was asked to get this archived as extensively as I can. Yeah, Greg Hallett feared disappeared by the Queen's minions. Greg Hallett claimed, so that's June 2014, Jim Fetzer, when I talked to him 1 year ago in November last year in 2014, Jim Fetzer was still saying that he believed on Remembrance Sunday that Greg Hallett had been topped. And when I began to talk to Jim Fetzer about the war crimes that I knew about and the jokes that ensue and take you back to the Roman court, all of them stopped talking about all of the issues, and the sun's dipped on that. That's the whole of the interlocking religious, geopolitical, genocidal, NATO-driven army campaigns that lead the world into conflict again and again. And Greg has explained that in his PDFs, and I've read it to you again and again, and all of the shocking pictures that show us that all of that is pre-planned by all of the people that lead the world and who can speak and write through all of the last 2,000 years. For the ordinary people, Greg has explained that that only started for us in 1914. Yeah, that was when they moved away from the poorhouse model and they moved into the education of the masses all across the globe. Yeah, and the history that we get is totally twisted, and the sport that we get from that is totally what drives everyone now. There is no integrity. None of the politicians have any capacity to do anything about changing the world to goodness and civilization, because they're too scared for the methods that are described in the old videos that Greg made. Yeah, that's the ones on Hitler, Stalin, FDR, and all of that stuff that I've been revealing to you, and all of the elite families that transit out of Europe, across Britain, across Ireland, into America, and then into every one of the global conflicts for a laugh, and that's the over there joke. Right, so then you see, so there are no numbers 1, 3, or 4 on the war issues, on the little blue dresses that impinge upon Bill Clinton's integrity, and all of the cover-ups by the news media of the little blue dress jokes about Ian Fleming and Intel. Intel still thrives. My wife denies that she's in Intel. All of the things that they have done are cheap shot tricks, and all of the money that is being sent to me is missing all of the things that I've made videos about. But let's keep on the genocide, yeah, because that's what the gods have asked me to do. I know my wife is a decent, simple woman, but she explains his persecution. Please listen to Greg Hallett's World of Truth number 5. It explains his persecution, disappearance, and silencing. They are seeking the same outcomes on my case. That must be one of the videos I've made, or it may be on my website. Okay, the Hallett Report, Greg Hallett, theworldoftruth.net, number 2. Yeah, I would be prepared to bet that that will not give me the transcript. Famous author Greg Hallett offers well-informed insights, the purpose of this. So here we get now the Christ stuff, yeah? Because when they knew I'm onto Christ as a fake, yeah, and it was Greg Hallett that told me about the Piso story, and it was him that referred me to it in the first place. None of them will talk about it now. Patterson does not talk about it at all. All of them just say, lop the head off David Cameron and let's get back to decency. Yeah, and all of them pretend that they are able to say that we can be freed by changes to ancient treaties, like the Treaty of I forget the mackerel place, the Treaty of Montrose, I think it is. Yeah, and there's Hallett Report number 9: Hitler, Stalin, Mao, Rothschilds. So those are new ones since I started to say that the new Hallett does not talk about the old topics. Okay, I'll watch that, because that one I've not seen before. But the, all of them were being presented by that Windows of the World man for a time. Yeah, totally unbelievable and incredible that that was the same thinker that was Greg Hallett before him. Okay, so Greg Hallett calls the Queen a fake, and here's all the stuff about the arguing about who's right and who's wrong. Yeah, Greg Crichton, final Mountbatten report, that's advertising of his books, the hard book cover book, final Mountbatten report. Yeah, and they're selling them now, and I'm kind of tempted to try and contact them at the office where they sell them. The Real Deal with Jim Fetzer podcast. So the ones with the Matt stuff. Okay, so that's only page one of hundreds of pages, but let's go to two. So you can see that the ones on the war and the ones... Queen has made no pretense that she's abdicated as declared in these videos, yet, and I've not heard of any mention of the royals in Portugal, but now that I'm making this video, the onus will be on the new Greg Hallett to get that into the limelight. They have been topped, I would suspect, yeah, and that is the knee-jerk response that these people use all of the time, which is why I'm intent on making videos until they take this home from me. Yeah, none of the media are on my case, only the New World Order plants and publicity engine that covers everything up are talking to me on Skype. Yeah, and the new topic for the people in Scotland is another Scottish referendum and the template that we should use. All of the referenda and elections are totally fudged. None of them can bring freedom until this is interrupted by an objective, evidence-based presentation of exactly who runs the world by planting actors into the parliament buildings in every parliament on the globe, and by planting revolutionaries and tank commanders into the regimes that are portrayed that way on every country in the globe. Okay, Hitler was a British agent, true crime solving. Yeah, so no mention of those missing three videos on in the 1-6 series that denounce all of the warmongering and all of the illegitimate royals through all of that time. The Queen Victoria story is incredibly still allowed to be told, because they're no longer breathing, you see. Was Hitler an Illuminati agent? Okay, so there's that's Henry Markow, and that's Markow, the cover in Poland for the birthplace of the Warner Brothers. Yeah, and they dare not talk now because I've revealed so much, and all of these people will have talked to Fetzer in the past. Yeah, and I don't know why Fetzer has now been mobilised by the new guy. It must be very, very difficult to be fooled into thinking that someone who's shocked you with his every statement is the new one. Okay, right then. So, let's go and open those ones, and I'll do my best to archive it. Yeah, because all of them are being taken down. Okay, so let's go back to that first page. That was my search term, Greg Hallett, World of Truth. And I can show you some emails from him declaring that I should send them. And he was disappeared on my Skype. I'm not sure whether it was December 2012. But all of those videos through all of that time talked about the meeting and all of the stuff that happened in the meeting at Cobham did change the laws of succession, and it was not anything to do with booting out the illegitimate royals that we have now, because what was announced beyond that and Greg's murder, I believe, was that the new claimants to the throne were to be the royal princes, and that is because of the injection of the royal blood that is in the videos that are missing. Yeah, that is the Dutch royals inseminating them, and the Plunketts and the people that are in the triumvirate doing the siring of the people that will be the next king. Okay, so let's start on number 6. Yeah, this is the last one he made. And this is the order that I looked at them this morning. And look at the website now. This is a really methodical and tidy man. Yeah, it is absolutely...
This is Jim Fetzer, your host on The Real Deal, with my very special guest, a return engagement. His last appearance here about the lack of legitimacy of the British crown drew a terrific response from listeners who want to hear more from one of the world's leading muckrakers and a personal favorite of mine, Greg Hallett. Greg, it's great to have you back on the air again.
Thank you, Jim. Thank you. I've got a lot to cover. I want to sort of clarify the separation between the true royal family and the dark side, all of the scandals that are going on at the moment. And I just want to separate the two, because the true royal family is very intellectual, high-minded, very well researched. So I'm going to...
There you go. That's all you get. Isn't that great? Yeah? You've seen me on those programs. You've seen Jim Fetzer talk his way out of continuing. There's no pretense here that he said something shocking. They're just declaring that you can't hear the rest. But blessedly, because of my pressure, they have left the text. So I'm going to read it to you now. So that's every interview that Jim Fetzer make. It's a series of half-hour sessions, and there are four of them in every interview. Every one I've made with him, we've had to cut it short, because the sensational stuff that I tell him, yeah, he's not prepared to release. Yeah, and he pretends that he's just discovered that he needs an operation a few days later, and he needs to bail out of the interview in the middle. Several times it's happened. Okay, and that's on the intervention on the Christianity thing. Okay, here's the pictures. And it is gusting like crazy again. Yeah. The abdication of Queen Elizabeth II. Okay, there's all the pictures. That's the one of Lionel Nathan Rothschild, I think it is, the King of Kings. That's the one with the goldfish for the penis, because he sires all of the European monarchy. And there are all the puppets, and this is the blue blood regimes, yeah, because all of them, they're in the bedroom raping and pillaging, and Queen Victoria never has a life. Okay, the abdication of Queen Elizabeth, we are now in an interregnum. So you saw how much time we got for that, 52 seconds on the 2 hour long interview, and I've listened to every one of these. They are fascinating. Right then, and there's the books, The Hidden King of England,
Arma Christi unveiling the right. Yeah. So it's no longer about the story that he told in episode 6 about the book being published with all of the pages published in the wrong order, yeah, and some of them published upside down, so it was totally incomprehensible. And that is in that interview over the next 2 hours, yeah, and that all of that was sensational at the time. And Jim Fetzer had to draw in his breath in a sensational way. Okay, Lord Chancellor Greg Hallett and Dr. Jim Fetzer, 14th January 2013. That must have been within days of his disappearance. I will check on my Skype when my last contact from him was advertising the books. And on my website you can see that I've got the images of Marcus Manuel, or whatever the Portuguese claimant now is, yeah, and the boy that was Marcus Manuel that was brought up on the Isle of Wight. We are now in an interregnum, okay? Hallett Report number 6. We can also click here to listen to the interview. That means I cannot start it and stop it, I think, to comment, but let's try.
This is Jim Fetzer, your host on The Real Deal, and my very special guest, a return engagement. His last appearance here about the lack of legitimacy of the British crown drew a terrific response from listeners who want to hear more from one of the world's leading muckrakers and a personal favorite of mine, Greg Hallett. Greg, it's great to have you back on the air again.
Thank you, Jim. Thank you. I've got a lot to cover. I want to sort of clarify the separation between the true royal family and the dark side, all of the scandals that are going on at the moment. And I just want to separate the two. The true royal family is very intellectual, high-minded, very well researched. So I'm going to...
Sorry. So I got eulogistic there. Okay, so I'm going to talk about Jacinta Saldana. Now this stuff is trivial, like Rebecca Brooks would use. This is about the killing of the nurse. Yeah, this is all the hallmarks of false news, and I don't really understand what they get from that. Because there's a news company in Australia makes a call to the birthing chamber for Kate Middleton, where I used to work, and where Guy Innes Kerr, the Duke of Roxburgh, has his babies, and refused to talk to me because he thought I was a press man. Yeah, that's the hospital that is run by Imperial College London, called St Mary's. That's the St Mary joke that all of you have become aware of, and not even Greg Hallett would talk about that. Okay, so I'm going to talk about Jacinta Saldana being suicided, and I don't know what's happened to the soundtrack there. That's probably the Intel Today just shutting me down like they do quite frequently. So I'll cover it myself. I'm going to talk about Jacinta Saldana being suicided and the apparent pregnancy of Kate Middleton and her sexual history, and how that parallels with some of our discoveries that were happening concurrently, and how it appears that Queen Elizabeth II has abdicated. Yeah, that seems a bit out of sync now, doesn't it? She abdicated in the best way that she could, knowing that her status is not that of a true queen, Queen Elizabeth II, or the invention of tradition called Queen Elizabeth II, fails to be the queen on several counts that have occurred during her lifetime from her birth and from her purported lineage going back to 1840. This is the thing that is upsetting everybody and has got me in the sectioned condition, yeah, and all of the people at Jedburgh Law Courts, all of them are complicit in massive modern day financial crimes. But this is the big issue, because they work for the crown, and that's the crown that runs all wars with the moneylenders, that runs all wars. It's the Rothschilds, and it's the cabal of people that wrote the Christian Bible as well.
Greg Hallett did not have the information or the courage on those things to release it in the public eye, because maybe he had the insight into what would happen to him. Okay? So when you see me on the street corners and homeless, realise that I'm working for the gods in disguise, and please give me the money for a sandwich now and again. I know people in borders already who live in a tent for the whole of their working year. I've worked with them. They also earn £32 a day for their sacrifice. And their name is Roy. That's the king. Okay? So, the British royal family that we've had from 1852 on has been illegitimate. Okay? You've heard that from me. You've seen the pictures. And those are the disappeared episodes, numbers 5, 4 and 3, right in the middle of the bundle. And all of the new ones are about bullshit religions and launching things in caves, yet none of it has been talked about before. Okay, illegitimate Queen Elizabeth II, that's her making her Christmas speech and using the Nazi Tannenbaum music to talk about the Christmas truth. And the Tannenbaum music is the tune that is the icon for the working man, the red flag, and the icon for fascism and Hitler in the Third Reich, when they're getting the Christmas presents to send to the troops, in inverted commas, like all of the charities now and all of the food bank scams. Yeah, it's just another money stream for her and her family, and that's the family that is Wilhelm on the other side of the conflict. And he has a laugh at the Royal Wives of Windsor, yeah, because that's the Shakespearean output. And all he does, yet he, in the lead up to, I think that was World War I though, in the lead up to World War I, Kaiser Bill was the head of the British Navy as a family member. Yeah? Okay, a person called Queen Elizabeth II is actually an inventor of tradition, carrying a 160-year line of illegitimate royals brought in concurrently with the British Empire becoming a mafia empire. So can you see in my videos why I'm carrying the flag? That's 163 years now. That's December of 2012, the year that they ran the Olympics joke, and Greg Hallett had to watch all of the mockery of Mr. Bean at the London Olympics. That's the bit that concerns me, that a loyalist like Greg, yeah, who talks about all of the crimes, does not talk about the interlocking crimes against his own troops, the Anzacs. It's stunning that he does not know that. Okay? So, there's the pictures. There's Winston Churchill, the Queen's sire. There's, I cannot name all of them. There's the real culprits. That's the Rothschilds and the British Central Bank, now run by the Canadian. That's a murderous one. Yeah, what we've had is a mafia royalty due to end from 2012. Okay, so that's when my world changed, because that is the time when this law started to impinge on me in my innocent living room. Me trying to get my jobs all around the place, including the jobs at the local council. Yeah, and none of them allow me to work for them. When I do get a job for them, I get scammed out of it because of my honesty and my integrity. And only people like the Duchess of Roxburgh are prepared to talk about issues like that. God bless you. Yeah, Lady Jane. That's the former Duchess. She got what I got. What we've had is a mafia royalty due to end from 2012. And that is Lionel Nathan Rothschild, financier. Okay? So let's do that as we get to it and we come down. And all of that is my recent videos. All of it is the little blue dress joke and all the cover-ups by the American presidents who are in these fucking bloodlines. That's Bill Clinton's dad too. Yeah, and the woman was Pamela Digby Churchill, that was his mum. Don't know what she looks like. That may be her. Okay? So, I'd love to talk to the real Greg Hallett, if he's still breathing. Yet, not about putting a new king or queen into the place to be filthy rich, but getting the democracy to usurp them and to make our world prosperous and peaceful. The person called Queen Elizabeth is actually an invention of tradition, carrying a 160-year line of illegitimate royals who were brought in concurrently. Remember, you're listening to this on that soundtrack there too. With the British Empire being a mafia empire, what we've had is a mafia royalty, and that was due to last for 200 years from 1812 to 2012. So now it's the time to bring it out, to show that the royal families that we've had from 1852 on have been illegitimate. So I thought I'd give you a brief rundown on the illegitimacy, just like a shorthand version of the previous interview, which is up on the video on theworldoftruth.net as Hallett Report number 5. Okay, that one's there. We can look at it, and I will in the course of time. Every one of the long videos I've made recently, I have to make twice because they crash it in the processing step. Don't know how they do that. Yeah, I was talking about Alec Nicol on the Kelso Bridge and the massive biblical flood that we had this weekend that totally destroyed the village of Hoyk, and that is where all of this illegitimacy hinges upon. Yeah, because that is blind Prince George of Cumbria and Teviotdale. And all of the papers, all of the media totally ignore all of that, and all of our democratic funding is dismembered as a result. Okay, that was the interview we did, recorded on the 30th of December and played by you on the 31st December 2012, kind of giving us the last word for 2012. That's when Hallett was disappeared and Fetzer never heard from him again. Queen Victoria had 9 official children. Before that, she had one child that was born legitimately and in marriage. That was Marcus Manuel. The other 9 children were born bigamously and from incest unbeknownst to Queen Victoria. And incest is not illegal if you don't know about it, but the person who sired the children did know. So that's the use of the date rape drug. Yeah. So he would be guilty of incest, and that was Lionel Nathan Rothschild as the siring partner. Okay? Those are the memory drugs that they used, I forget what that one is, and the Rohypnol, it makes you unconscious, and there's the sire, and that is a picture from the Punch magazine, which I've now disclosed is run in the modern days by Dodi Fayed's dad, Al Fayed, who runs the Ritz. Yeah, and they kill Princess Diana, and on and on and on it goes. Okay, the other 9 children were born bigamously and from incest, unbeknownst to Queen Victoria, and incest is not illegal if you don't know about it, but the person who sired the children did know, so he would be guilty of incest, and that was Lionel Nathan Rothschild as the siring partner. Prince Consort Albert didn't sire any of Queen Victoria's official 9 children. So the next person to reign after Queen Victoria died on the 22nd, now Fetzer is not asking any questions, quite stunning. So the next person to reign after Queen Victoria died on the 22nd of January 1901 was King Edward VII, who also knew that his elder legitimate half-brother was alive. So King Edward VII's coronation was delayed for 18 months from the 22nd of January 1901 to the 9th of August 1902. At the same time, King Edward VII got the Secretary of War, Lord Kitchener, to alter the mandate of Freemasonry, which was originally about keeping the true monarch on the throne, and he changed it to whatever it is today. Yeah, that's all of those massive palaces that I showed you in the earlier videos. In the colonies, like in New Zealand, it's extremely corrupt and supports massive wrongdoings, and the same is true of other countries as well. All countries across the globe, yet are totally owned by this cabal, or the mafia as Greg calls it. So there is a correction there that needs to be made. Now, King Edward VII and his reign from 1901 to 1910 organised the murder of the Portuguese royal family, organised the abdication of the next royal family, organised the murder of his legitimate older half-brother, and then passed instructions on to his son, King George V, who reigned from 1910 to 1936, to assassinate the exiled King of Portugal, King Manuel II of Portugal, in Twickenham, in South London. Yeah, that is not Carlos I, that's another execution in Portugal, so that the British royals could take over all of Portuguese colonial North Africa. That's a video that I've made totally independently of this story, which is why I don't want another monarchy. Yeah, it is a menace. Yeah, and the courtiers are just the profiteers, and they're the money lenders that in this case sire the babies and give them the syphilis. Okay, and then we had, so he's murdered in King Manuel II. That's the one who was born on the Isle of Wight. Yeah, that's where the Hastios come in, and all of the drug running covers, and Hastio being released from the Isle of Wight, and the Clark man. Yeah, and all of my friends come into my life from the south of England, opposite the Isle of Wight, and they're clerks. And they tell me that my video quality is not good, but they're generous and decent enough to offer to buy me some kit. And they're still my friends, and I really appreciate them for that. So that destroyed the last vestiges, or thereabouts, of the last vestiges of the Portuguese royal family. And then we had, from 1936 to 1936, January to December, we had King Edward VIII, who was never crowned, and then we had King George VI, from 1936 to 52, who was crowned, but he was retarded. This is the stammering joke. Okay? And he had a child with the person referred to as the Queen Mother, or Elizabeth Bowes Lyon, and that child turned out to be epileptic. So King George VI was removed from being the siring male. He was replaced with Winston Churchill, who was the illegitimate son of King Edward VII. So there was still some supposed royal blood there. Do you see the motives for switching the dad? And that's the now famous picture with the cross on it on King George VI, saying, not the father, but putting Winston up there with the V fucking sign. Yeah, on the balcony at the house that was bought to them. That's Buckingham Palace, where I've gone with my children and my disloyal wife, and we've looked through the massive statues and things that are outside of it, all of it immune from bombing through World War II, but gifted to them by the four blind princes of by the four princes. That's the Alf Garnett videos that were the kings of Hanover. You cannot have a queen in Hanover, and that is the hoik common riding joke. Yeah, because the Teviot Valley runs right through hoik, which is why 600 houses this week were evacuated in the biblical flood, and all of the Freemasons, particularly those that run the Walter Scott Club and the Abbotsford Trust, yeah, all of them know that all of this means that the royals become coercible over time, and that becomes a massive profit stream for you. And if you're the Buccleuch, you take over the property after they've been evicted from it, and 80 million people are already dead in British and German uniforms. The German ones are in the same colours as the Hoik rugby team. The sun has gone in a major way. So King George VI was removed from being the siring mate. He was replaced with Winston Churchill, who was the illegitimate son of King Edward VII. So there was still some supposed royal blood there, but it was from incest. King Edward VII was a warlord. Winston Churchill, his biological son, was also a warlord. Okay? Yeah, there they are. There's Churchill, there's Stalin. And FDR, his story came out on the weekend, just before the biblical flood, and the waters rose in Kelso to a level I've never seen before, and they managed to infiltrate all across the Springwood Park showfield. Yeah, all across it. It was under a massive flood. And that's Springwood that trades flowers with Holland, where FDR came from. And the flowers joke is the Piso translation, and it's the floors joke too. Yeah, that is Floors Castle that was in the back of those biblical flood videos. Yeah, right on top of the hill, and the man there is Guy Ineos Kerr, which is Guy Jesus Kerr. All of them are in it up to their necks. Yeah, and that's what they do. Yeah, if you're a treasonous leader, yeah, they proclaim that you are totalitarian, yeah, that's the Aryan master race joke, then they proclaim that you're communist, and that starts the Cold War, and everybody is perpetually in conflict.
and there's the little red fez that killed Tommy Cooper at the London Palladium in the presence of Winston Churchill's daughter, Queen Elizabeth II. So there was still some supposed royal blood there, but it was from incest. King Edward VII was a warlord. Winston Churchill, his biological son, was also a warlord. Elizabeth Bowes Lyon was initially engaged to the person who became King Edward VIII, who reigned, that's the abdicated king now, the Paris party man, who reigned January to December 1936. He told her he was going to abdicate, so then she was given the option to become engaged to the person who became King George VI. But he had knocked knees and was one IQ point above retarded, so she brought in her whipping boy. Yet that's the one who everybody loves. Okay? To become engaged and then marry King George VI. That's the Queen Mum that loves the races. And that's the GG fucking joke again. Okay? Now the whipping boy is somebody that an aristocrat is raised with. And sometimes it doubles for them in photos. And sometimes there's two photos taken with, say, the brother, where Elizabeth Bowes Lyon is photographed as a child with the brother. Yeah, there's the murderous one. Any trace of a true royal was removed from history books and or their throne. This was the work of the illegitimate bastard king, Edward VII. His coronation was due to his illegitimacy. During his 16 and a half month interregnum, the mandate of the Freemasonry was changed. Yeah? And you've seen the Rothschilds that sired them up above. Okay? And sometimes there's two photos taken. And so this is the whipping boy story and the Queen Mother that lived way up on the north coast of Scotland at Caithness. So what you've got is a photographic opportunity to show a complete history, and the whipping boy came from Waterford in Ireland, and the Irish accent had to be taught out of it, so it was more of a Scottish brogue. The true Elizabeth Bowes Lyon got married and lived in France and died in 1950. And I got this from a British and European royal who is incredibly renegade. So I don't know who that is, and no one is allowed to know. So Elizabeth Bowes Lyon's whipping boy married King George VI, and then Winston Churchill provided the sperm for the artificial insemination with Elizabeth Bowes Lyon's whipping boy, resulting in Princess Elizabeth, who was born above the Coach and Horses pub in Mayfair in London. And all of these stories are spookily intertwined with my family living in Crewe in Cheshire and living above pubs. Yet the whole of my story, what they want to happen is to have it look like this man never lived. Yeah, and because Google own the internet and everything that I make, that will be the case unless the gods intervene first. And I'm stacking my cards up on that supposition. Yeah, what happened on the weekend was absolutely majestic. Okay, King Edward VII's reign was flat lie royal, 1901 to 1910, illegitimate, void. Since then, the throne has been usurped by illegitimates. There's Princess Diana. There is one of the goldsmiths. Yeah, I think that was maybe her parent. And there is Prince Charlie, Camilla. Yeah, she should see her now. That's Simon Day. He's got a body double in Kelso. That could be his whipping boy. Yeah, he's a bastard child of those pair when she was 18 and he was 17 with the big lugs. There's King Juan Carlos, who sired him by her. And there is Middleton. And the Middletons are not commoners at all. They interlock with Longshanks and the Dukes of Norfolk, as you now know. And the horsey story is all through the crime scene. Yeah, and there's the ones that are the parents of him. Yeah, he's the royal man who's the equerry or something in the court. Yeah, she's in love with him, and then they sire him. And he's prepared to kill if the cause is right, and that was declared when they went back into Argentina, yeah, to run the oil scams there and to frighten the people that we'd have another war with them. Okay? And there's something with massive ears, which is a joke. I don't know who that is. Okay? So, they lived above the Coach and Horses in Mayfair in London.
And my sister went all the way down to where all of those elites live. Yeah, and that's why Queen Elizabeth II's nickname is Lilibeth La Bonne, meaning the maid. That meant she was the daughter of the maid, the daughter of the whipping boy. Then when George V died in 1952, the very illegitimate Princess Elizabeth became Queen Elizabeth II. Can you see why the real Greg Hallett has been disappeared? He was braver than me. He did not just write to her and a few disloyal doctors. Yeah, he wrote, and the MPs and all of the people that run our corrupted governments, yeah, he wrote directly to Queen Elizabeth II, but he had broadcast it all for a couple of decades when he lived in New Zealand as a loyal Kiwi. Okay? In 1946, Prince Philip became engaged to Princess Elizabeth under the extortion of Lord Louis Mountbatten. Yeah, it's a lethal, lethal place. Yeah, he eventually gets topped by the man who he nominated. Lord Louis Mountbatten extorted the whipping boy, Queen Consort Elizabeth, and King George VI on the basis that the royal family had been fake since 1852. So in order to retain the crown, they sold their daughter into marriage to Prince Philip, and it appears that Lord Louis Mountbatten also included rights for underage sex with the firstborn, prima nocte, droit de seigneur, right of the lord, where the lord takes the virginity of the serfs, and that was Prince Charles. Poor man. Yet no wonder he's so meek. Yet he's also covered, he has total immunity from prosecution or accusations of anything that you've done. But can you see why they would be brought up in fear? Yeah, because things like that happened to them. Also to Princess Sophie, allegedly. And there's the photos of Prince Charles and Lord Louis Mountbatten shaking hands at a polo event when Prince Charles was still quite young. Can't see that. Jim Fetzer, Greg, would you repeat that? He had the first rights to sex. So Fetzer is still awake. I don't know whether he's still alive, since I tried to make the interview when I showed them all that Bill Clinton and the Monica Lewinsky joke is the same fucking joke. And that's what precipitated the biblical floods, with the FDR warmongering and all of the stuff about America and all of those regimes being trained in Tavistock, and all of the stuff about Brookings and the skulls and everything that happens in those warmongering universities like Georgetown and Princeton, where Jim Fetzer went to, incidentally. I don't think he replied to that casual question that I asked him the other day. And there's photos of Prince Charles and Lord Louis Mountbatten shaking hands at a polo event when Prince Charles was still quite young. Greg, would you repeat that? He had the first rights to sex? Yes. Sex? Yes. Sex? Yes. Okay? Lord Louis Mountbatten had the first rights to sex with the firstborn of Queen Elizabeth and Prince Philip, which was Prince Charles. So Prince Charles was a paedophile victim from obviously a young age. He is not next in line for the throne, I'm led to believe, because of the laws of succession that changed in 2012. Okay? But that is not mentioned here. I've had to assume that from my own insight. Okay? Lord Louis Mountbatten was absolutely known for his paedophilia, and he was known for having schools under his own name, like Mountbatten School in Singapore. And one of the pupils there spoke to me. He would have been in his mid to late 50s, and he was saying that it was his role to meet Lord Louis Mountbatten at the gate when he was about 5 or 6 years old. And after that, he couldn't remember what happened in the next few days. And then he started to have very adult thoughts flashing across his mind, like sexual thoughts. And it appears that Lord Louis Mountbatten was testing drugs for Roche. Yet they worked in Basel when I was there. They ran their company in Basel, like Ciba Geigy and one other massive pharma magnate. Yeah, and because I'm there, and they know that I'm coming after them, they had the massive mercury spill into the Rhine. Yeah, and all of the eco scandals are fundraisers for the royals too, including Darken and Silence and date rape drugs, and using it for sex with children. The memory drugs are atropinics, and they are horribly toxic. The atropinics are a bit like the nerve gases that were used in the trenches. I forget the name of the really notorious one. Now, another people have also brought Now, other people have also brought out that Lord Louis Mountbatten is a paedophile. Now Lord Louis Mountbatten introduced the well-known paedophile Jimmy Savile to Prince Charles. They used to spend quite a lot of time together and go to parties together. A lot of it was under the guise of charity events. On Jimmy Savile's 80th birthday, Prince Charles sent Jimmy Savile a pair of cufflinks, a box of cigars, and a note saying, "No one will ever know what you've done for this country." There's now just a phenomenal amount of children that Jimmy Savile's abused. And it appears that Prince Charles was definitely not the father of Prince William and is not the father of Prince Harry. And it was Princess Diana who ensured this, possibly on the knowledge that she knew A, definitely that Prince Charles was having a long-standing affair with Camilla Parker Bowles, and that Prince Charles may have been a paedophile. And that may be why the current laws of succession are completely bypassing Prince Charles. Prince Philip and Lord Louis Mountbatten also had sexual relations. Prince Philip was also known for getting drunk on Royal Navy ships, yeah, and then falling over on the stomach so that he could be sodomised. And some of the sailors who sodomised him told co-researchers of mine that, oh yeah, I had Prince Philip. So he was quite into sodomy and into children. And now on Sandringham Estate in Norfolk, they are finding lots of bodies of children and women buried around in the yards. Don't know how any of that can be proven. Yeah, all of it comes into all of the stories. So it looks like Prince Philip, who extorted his marriage with Princess Elizabeth, is a paedophile who then agreed to marry Princess Elizabeth, and that the firstborn would be sodomised as a child by Lord Louis Mountbatten. Jim Fetzer, this is all so unbelievably disgusting. Greg, well, what was the location where the bodies of women and children have been found again? Greg Hallett, Sandringham House, which is actually Sandringham Palace. And my niece lives right next door to those places. She took us there when I went with my loyal family. And strangely enough, I felt really sorry for her. She's a nice person. She's a school teacher. Her house was filled with rats. Yeah, I don't understand how to interpret that. But in the, you know, the brickwork of her house, there were loads of rat carcasses. And it's actually on the Dragon Line that runs from Transylvania, where Prince Charles has bought a lot of properties. It's where the Dracula Castle is. So, Jim Fetzer says, are you implying then that the graves have been dug up, that these bodies have been unearthed? And if so, who is responsible for that? Yet none of it appears in the British press. Yeah, but when the Queen does the Nazi sign, the week that I expose all of her massive holdings, yeah, she's immediately on the front page of the papers, even on a Sunday. So are you implying then that the graves have been dug up, that these bodies have been unearthed, and if so, who's responsible for that? Yes, is Greg, but the problem is that, you remember, you're listening to this on that soundtrack. Yeah. The problem is that Queen Elizabeth owns the court buildings, so there's no hearings in court against the Queen. Yet that's my problem at Jedburgh. Have these bodies then been excavated, as you imply, and if so, by whom? They have been exhumed, and they were buried randomly, not as graves, and they were buried not to be hidden, and investigations are ongoing. You can bet your boots that that is a lie. None of the police will take on anything that happens in the world-owning cabal. That's why they're named polis. It's got the word piso in it. I mean, Jim Fetzer then says, I mean, yes, if they were buried randomly, it would be very difficult to locate them. I think it's remarkable that they discovered, you imply, quite a few. Greg Hallett, there are quite a few bodies there. So we've got the sexual indiscretions of Prince Philip, who is married to Queen Elizabeth. Now Prince Philip used to keep a black British taxi. Gets really entertaining here. Okay, and my wife's gonna write a book, she told me. Yeah, no doubt I will end up with a reputation like Hitler if they have their way with me. I'm reliant on the gods yet to change all of that. I will not stop talking until they top me. Now Prince Philip used to keep a black British taxi, a London taxi, and a chauffeur's cap, and he used to put his chauffeur's cap on, get in the taxi and drive to a brothel and walk as so he was going to pick someone up, and then he would stay in the brothel. And one of his favourite sex hunting buddies was Kate Middleton's father. Jim Fetzer, one of his favourite sex hunting buddies, exclamation mark. Yeah, so there is a sex hunting connection between Kate Middleton's father and Prince Philip. Jim Fetzer then says, this was for the purpose of paedophilia. Is Kate's father also a paedophile? Greg Hallett then says, if you think of the movie Eyes Wide Shut, it is kind of everything goes party, but what they show you in the movie is very tall, skinny, model-like girls, generally in their 20s. Apologies to the Vash for playing the Valerie song yeah, in yesterday's issues. If you think of the movie Eyes Wide Shut, it's kind of everything goes. That's the film that gave orgies a bad name. Can you remember the royal children being pictured by Berlusconi's press in orgies, yeah, when all of this was released? All of it. The media are puppets to cover up the truth, or even allegations about what the truth is in the elite families that run the world and all wars. That's the film that gave orgies a bad name. Greg Hallett, Kate Middleton is good friends with the owner of Killing Kittens Sex Club, and Killing Kittens offers a sexual service like Eyes Wide Shut, which is the tall, skinny, model-like women. So it appears that Prince Philip was got together with Kate Middleton's father and arranged an Eyes Wide Shut type event. Now they've got two registrations, one's in the central of London and one is in rural Kent. Yeah, I've got the director numbers. Kate Middleton and Prince... So, Middleton's father arranged an Eyes Wide Shut type event with Kate Middleton, Prince William, and then used that to, wait for it, entrap Prince William into marriage and therefore make Prince William completely controllable. Yeah, this is the era when we cannot smack our children. And I have been accused of no bad behaviours, but I'm losing everything I worked for, yeah, as a molecular neuroscientist and a professor of drug science, and they're prepared to section me with all of this going on in their leadership team's bedrooms or brothels. And Greg Hallett's the man who revealed that you could not have sex as an ordinary working man, but you could be killed in the summer wars, so that everybody has available women and orphan children, and the Catholic Church revel in that too. Okay? So, Prince William is coerced into the woman from the brothel, if it's true, yet there's no way that anyone can know how many of these are the same as the federated scams that are the protection rackets all over Europe since the Roman Empire got so big that it could not own itself in the provinces. Yet that's the FIFA jokes and all of the jokes about the affairs that Sepp Blatter has had. All of the real news is released by me from this lovely living room that I may not be in 1 month's time. Yeah? I may be in the Sandringham sector. Do you get the irony of that? That's our world leaders. Now, since the monarchy is illegitimate and all the parties in it have been illegitimate since the birth of Queen Victoria's second child, Princess Vicky, Queen Consort Elizabeth and Winston Churchill, the real parents of Queen Elizabeth and Princess Margaret. Okay? And there's the picture of Phil the Greek. Yeah, he's in charge of MI6 and all of the intel and the assassinations of Prince Charles' real wife. Yeah, that's Princess Diana. So, it's illegitimate. All the parties have been illegitimate since the birth of Queen Victoria's second child, Princess Vicky. She lived on the Isle of Mull, where I went fishing with my wife, and we saw the royal yacht in the channel between the mainland and everything that happens in my life. So that is, she married Argyll from the Braveheart movie and lived on Mull in a massive Irish mansion that was black and sinister, and I only learned that this year. I've written to them asking for a quotation for a week's visit next summer. They did not reply. Then whoever has the most control over the monarchy gets to run the monarchy, and it appears that Kate Middleton is an agent in a similar way that JFK's wife and Miss VJ Lees is an agent.
Jackie Kennedy, who became Jackie Onassis, was an agent. She moved from President of the United States to one of the biggest shipping magnate and heroin traffickers on the planet, Aristotle Onassis, and then she moves to the Diamonds Man. I've got no idea what's in my wife's head. Yep, she knows that she's super intelligent. She could bring the whole world back to decency by doing the decent thing. And we temporarily talked about that. Yeah, on the bridge on Saturday, when she came to see the biblical flood that she and her friends are perpetrating, yeah, by being loyal to this totally corrupted system, because she's an agent and she worked in Marks and Spencer, in Baker Street, and in all over the place. And all of that video that I've made, yeah, on Bonner Law, Butlins, the Ashridge College, and all of the stuff that happened at Bunsfield in Hemel Hempstead, where she came from, everything that has happened in her career has been stalked by intel people. Yeah, and all of it is associated with massive financial frauds, and I've named all of the people in that video. Okay, so the people that are given their wives by the Freemasons that are run earlier on in the story, yeah, that was explained. Yeah, they're the drug runners, and that's the FDR video I made the other day that precipitated the massive floods. And whenever Aristotle Onassis got in trouble with his heroin trafficking, he would call in the highest diplomat that he could to fluff around so that anyone who wanted to charge him would be too embarrassed to charge him. And the person who used that used for that was Winston Churchill. So post World War II, Winston Churchill spent a lot of time with Aristotle Onassis, so the Eyes Wide Shut type sex club like Killing Kittens, which Kate Middleton is associated with, links to the drug trafficking. And there are a lot of reports, actually, on ongoing reports of Prime Minister David Cameron, his father being a ship jumper between the heroin and the money, taking the heroin over and taking the money back. Yeah, and that's Camerinus in the Roman court. All of them are the same families through all of the world lineage, and this sort of thing can only happen with an, and he's also Cameron of Lochiel in the Scottish vast tracts of land sector, and this, and they're probably the Camerons of McGill University who invented electroconvulsive therapy in psychiatry. And this sort of thing can only happen with an illegitimate monarchy. And Queen Elizabeth II doesn't have any say in the matter, because Lord Louis Mountbatten and Prince Philip have extorted Princess Liz. Yeah? She's still loyal, though, because no one dare step in their murderous path. Yeah? Have extorted Princess Elizabeth into marriage and control of their children, including Lord Louis Mountbatten's sex with Prince Charles, and the parentage of the other children. A triumvirate formed for the heroin trafficking, which involved Prince Philip, Lord Porchester and Lord Plunkett. And it appears that Queen Elizabeth II, who is virtually a slave because she's compromised, that she had a child with the heroin trafficker Lord Porchester, called Prince Andrew, and then she had a child with the heroin trafficker Lord Plunkett. Yeah, these are my heroes that write the fishing novels, or their ancestry are. Yeah, Lord Plunkett called Prince Edward. Okay, all of them born by people to get the legitimacy back. I don't know how that works with lords from the provinces. And then Prince Philip had sex with Prince Edward's wife, Sophie Rhys-Jones, and produced their child. So in compromising the royal family, Prince Philip, who was initially an outsider, has taken control of the British royal family. He has turned it into a paedophile, heroin trafficking and Nazi organisation, which is not a royal family at all. The British royal family, as they were, are illegitimate, is completely destroying the United Kingdom from within. Yet, all of that is totally undeniable. If you listen to that for 10 minutes any morning, you get confirmation of that. All of Scotland has sold its integrity, and all of the people that play the role of the actors are doing exactly the same thing as every one of the villains in this story. Yet just for a cheap shot bung and to dismember the whole of what could be a civilised world. Greg, this looks like the perfect opportunity to take our first break. Jim Fetzer with a revisionist history par excellence, Greg Hallett, discussing the royal family and many bizarre aspects. We'll be right back. So do you remember those pauses that Jim makes when I'm being interviewed by him? There's Kate, the prostitute. She's lovely. Yeah. And you can see that the royal princes are quite happy with their lot, because they're still running the show. Yeah. And they are still the heads of the British Army, Navy and Air Force. And the man that limps along the Kelso pavements told me that I'm mistaken in that. I've got all the documents, all of them are published on my website. This is Jim Fetzer, your host on The Real Deal, continuing my conversation with Greg Hallett. Yeah. Greg, you made an observation in passing, characterising Jackie Kennedy as an agent. I would like some elaboration on that. Yeah, look at the pictures of her smiling as she puts down the broom at JFK's funeral. Yeah, it always seemed to me that Jackie actually decided to marry Onassis because he was the richest man in the world, and she felt he could provide protection for her and her children. Not that there was anything malevolent going on under the surface. Yeah, Greg Hallett is one of the world's experts on conditioning people and mind control training. Yeah. I mean, it always seemed to me that Jackie was actually politically very naive, that while she knew a great deal about culture, literature, art, music and so forth, that she was virtually oblivious to the political ramifications and shady goings on in the world. Yeah, same with my wife. She's absolutely enthralling in conversation, yet she can encapsulate anybody in a civilized chat. She would not talk to me about anything, because in the end, I become the fraud researcher, and everything she does, I'm onto. So I'd really appreciate some elaboration on what point you're making here. Greg Hallett, it's my understanding she was a Mossad agent, a bit like Mandy Rice Davis and Christine Keeler. Yeah, I've got their history too. That is the actor also who played Richie Rich. Yet they're from the same region where I got my massive concussions and ended up in hospital on the Thames Valley. Okay, and all of that is a joke, because they appear in the BBC interviews together. That takes you right back to William the Conqueror and the earliest regimes in the Thames Valley. Probably the best example is when JFK was shot, which you're a world expert in, if not the world expert. An hour and a half later, she was on Air Force One as the witness to Lyndon B. Johnson becoming the American president. That's Jimmy Johnson in the Celtic team, same world owners, all over every continent on the globe. She appeared to be utterly and totally calm, wasn't a wreck at all. Jim Fetzer, my take is she was in a state of semi-shock. Lyndon inappropriately took control of JFK's plane, which was completely unnecessary. He didn't even need to be sworn in. But the introduction of the needless events of swearing in, provided opportunity to move his luggage from Air Force 2 to Air Force 1, also completely unnecessary. But more importantly, I'm convinced to offload the body of JFK and transport it to Air Force 2, or at least to a compartment in Air Force 1. This is much more trivial, and all of that crime remains unsolved for all of that human history. The acts of God thing associated with JFK's murder was the massive winter that we had that year, and you could walk over the River Tweed where I portrayed the massive biblical flood we had this week, and below the arches, yeah, and that is a massive flood, and it was a freezing winter, and the countryside all around us was frozen right into April. I'm convinced to offload the body of JFK and transport it to Air Force One, from which he was offloaded at Andrews Air Force Base into a helicopter and then flown to Walter Reed Army Medical Center. So this is just Jim Fetzer's expertise. Let's get back to the royals. That was Lyndon Johnson's machination. He arranged all of that and wanted her to give a visual appearance of legitimacy of succession from the Kennedy to the Johnson administration. This is theworldoftruth, all one word, .net, /Hallett Report, /6, HTML. What's that symbol there? And then .vma1nnklrkg. Hallett Report number 6, World of Truth. You can look it up for yourself.
So back to Greg Hallett. He was very definitely in a hurry to do that, but she didn't appear to be, from the photos I've seen, in a state of shock. We can discuss that for a long time, but there are sex slaves and they're allowed to see some of them publicly, and Marilyn Monroe was another sex slave that they were allowed to see publicly. So Jim Fetzer then says, well, Marilyn certainly got around and had lots and lots of affairs and dalliances, including with JSK and more seriously with Bobby. Greg Hallett, yes. So I mean, all that is rather well documented in a number of fascinating books. One entitled, as I recall, MM at the End of the Rainbow, which is a particularly fascinating work. That's the M word that keeps coming up. It's the M in Tinker, Toller, Tailor, Soldier, Spy, and it's the M in the Bond novels, yeah, about James Bond. Some of the, and it's the M that is the manufacturer of the transportation cages for the nuclear weapons that works with the Bredenkampf team and pretends to be a loyalist, and he's the one that lost me my job because they did not allow me to go to work on the river at Selkirk on a Sunday with no notice because I was talking about saving Syria from carpet bombing. Okay, some of the sex workers or sex club workers or killing kittens workers or eyes wide shut workers are actually classy looking women in long sleeved shirts. They don't all sort of wear bikinis and, you know, act like hookers. Some of them are very high class and they are intelligence gatherers. Oh, Lady Jane, I hope your motives are innocent. Marilyn Monroe had 161 IQ. She was supposed to have seduced Brezhnev and got secrets from him, and I think that Marilyn actually worked with Jackie Kennedy in a similar realm. They both worked on Brezhnev together, and Marilyn Monroe was actually the brighter of the two, although she didn't look it. And a lot of the women who can flirt very well are actually highly intelligent, and they can be compartmentalised so that they retain everything that's been spoken and everything they've seen. Like my wife, she was very proud of it when I saw her when she went to look at the biblical flood on Sunday. What I want to do is talk about, if Queen Elizabeth was never crowned, and it is not who she says she is, and she was never crowned because the stone of Scone was not under the chair or throne that she sat on when she was crowned, and her mother is not who she says her mother is, and her father is not who she says her father is. Jim Fetzer then says, so it was a deliberate contrivance that the stone, and all of this is ancient history. What difference does it make? Yeah, constitutionally, it's a nonsense side issue. Yeah, but everybody keeps talking about its importance. So it was deliberate contrivance, yet that it was been stolen so many times, and it's not even sure that and this is like the Holy Grail, it's on every church roof all over the world. It's been stolen, returned, stolen, replaced, stolen again and hidden, and that may be the part of the shin which went from 1812 to 2012 and from 1852 on, especially from 1901 to 1902 on, and it was done so there would be no legitimate kingship under the truly kingly descendants come back until they returned at the end of the shin, which was from the 19th September 2012. Okay, legitimate monarchy is absent until the return of the true royal family. So this is Greg talking up his Portuguese mates and the surviving lineage. So the security at Westminster Abbey, says Fetzer, is simply not that great that the stone can be repeatedly stolen. Oh God, I mean, it would seem, I visited the Abbey and it was not obvious to me how much surveillance of security was present, but it's fairly remarkable that an object of such extreme historical and even legal or quasi-legal significance should be repeatedly taken. Greg then says, and it's been taken for a reason, and those who took it having inside knowledge on why it should be taken. So what we've got is a situation where it appears that Queen Elizabeth II has abdicated, and that she abdicated on the 28th of October of 2011. Yeah, my separation date. As best as she could, yeah, everything they do is an attempt to shut me up. She was not actually the legitimate queen. That's also the sectioning date for Dr. Finlay's first crooked attempt when he steals all of that 40 grand a year from every British patient to put them in the care homes that they have now privatised and passed on from the public sector to the private profiteering sector that all of this represents. So, she abdicated on the